Hello everyone, and welcome to the first race of the weekend, and that is the CGP3 series here at the Sochi Autodrome. Here at the Sochi Autodrome, in what is set to be a very interesting first race of the weekend. It's dry, but we should see some good racing here at Sochi. But we are almost set for the first race of the weekend in CGP3, what is set to be an interesting race. It's been a good weekend for MAT. It's Puccini on pole position. We are obviously going to give you a run on the grid as they do their formation lap, of course. So we're just getting ready to get this CGP3 race underway. In what should be an interesting one. We're almost ready. So they're just getting onto the grid now. So everyone's just getting into their positions. With Puccini, what a qualifying from her. And so just getting underway, they pull away for their formation lap now. And as they do their formation lap, not to switch it to the scene, we're going to give you a rundown of the grid. In pole position for the CGP3 race here in Sochi, it is Alicia Puccini ahead of Conor Ellis, who lines up in second. Alex Chittup lines up in third ahead of Dan Farnham in fourth, in the third of the three Casey cars. Fifth on the grid, it is Joey Brolic ahead of Jacob Arnott in sixth, with Austin Harper in seventh. Ben Evans starts in eighth after he's off the back of the grid the last time out in Bahrain. Ninth on the grid, we have Charlie Flynn ahead of Miles Hanawin in tenth in the Hamilton Cup. Danny McDonald lines up in 11th, and Harry Herdman in 12th, Claire Chippico in 13th, and Gaspar Melli-Allier in 14th. Jenna Blake lines up in 15th, in the first of racing, in fact, the distance was over her. Ahead of Hazel Bowman in 16th, Benny Flight in 17th, and Lisa Temnikova at her home race in 18th. Ollie Thomas lines up in 9th, ahead of Jake Morgan in 20th. Aaron Bird lines up in 21st, and Gina Dicker 22nd. Lisa Rowey in 23rd, Jack Moss 24th, Joe Rocklin in 25th, Ollie Gord in 26th, Josh Groffy 27th, Nikolai Mabou 28th, with Matt Jones and Sam Venable rounding out the grid. And that is your grid for the first race of the weekend for the CGP3 race here in Sochi. 26 laps the drivers have to do round here today. As the drivers head into the final corner. Puccini gets into her grid slot. As the drivers are just lining up on the grid. The CRC racers will be watching this very closely to see what can be done, because it's a different version of the track to last year. But here we go. We have the lights illuminate above the drivers. And when they go out, we're racing. It's a good start there from Puccini. Not the best of starts from Ennis. And he's already going to be under attack from Alex Chetton, who already is going to go round the outside of Conor Ennis and might go down the inside of Alessio Puccini on the run down towards the first corner. Is Chetton going to get down the inside? Puccini holds the lead. But Chetton barges his way down the inside. It looks like they are all round turn two safely. They're going to be side by side going into turn three. Who is it going to be who's going to exit turn three of the lead? Alessio Puccini just holds it and leads the way as they head up towards turn four for the first time. It's Puccini who leads from Chittuk, Farnham, Ellis, Arnish, Harper, Rolick, Evans, Flynn and Hanawin round out the top 10. Are we going to see any incidents here? Ben Evans trying to get down the inside of Joey Rolick, who hasn't had the best of starts. But somehow Puccini... Oh, we got a spin! That is Miles Hanawin! And that is Harry Herdman coming together. They all managed to recover from that. But already we have a bit of carambolage on the first lap, so where did that happen? And so you've got Alex Chittuk, who's now right behind Alessio Puccini. And we've got another yellow out there. There's been an incident somewhere. Oh, we've got massive carnage. That's Ben Evans, who's had an incident with someone. I'm not sure who, but Ben Evans has had contact with someone. But a very interesting first lap indeed. Puccini leads at the end of the first lap, but he's going to struggle to get away from Alex Chittuk, to be honest, in the D-Tech. But I don't think the D-Tech's going to be close enough just yet going into turn one, unless he can send one straight up the inside. We're going to have a look at those incidents now, what actually happened in those incidents between... Firstly, there was an incident where Miles Hanawin got into a spin. So what happened there to Miles Hanawin? So he managed to spin it and almost collected Dan Farnham. All got cut off by, I think that was Gaspar Merdialia. And then what happened to Ben Evans down the down in towards this corner at the end of DRS. Oh, he got tagged by Charlie Flynn. So Charlie Flynn tagged Ben Evans, so Puccini's starting to get away a little bit. But Chittuk is not leaving Puccini alone here as they head up towards, not sure what corner number it is. Some very interesting racing we're seeing here today. Turn 14 it is that we're talking about. And Dan Farnham is now starting to look really close to the back of Alex Chittuk. And I think he might have a go. Gonna look from behind from Puccini, because she might get a good view of all of this. Chittuk goes to the inside to fend from the Casey car. Bit of contact, and that's allowed Puccini to get away a little bit. Very interesting though. And we got a smoking engine from someone. I think that's from either Thomas or Baldwin. So someone's engine is really smoking badly. And I think it is Hazel Baldwin who's got the... I think she is going to have to stop the car sometime soon. Got a yellow out there. I think that might be for Hazel Baldwin, who brought her car to a stop. Her race only lasting 3 laps. It'll be very interesting to see what's going to happen in the pit stops. But not many people making moves yet here in this race. But you've got Dan Farnham, who is starting to look very close. To continue to look very close to Alex Chittor. And he might have the run here, going up towards turn two, but I don't think he's going to be close enough this time though. But Connor Ellis, I thought, was going to have a little look down the inside. You've got Joey Vrolik right behind Austin Harper. By the way, I cannot look at the stream chat, so if you're putting any comments in, I don't know. Charlie Flynn, having a look at the back of Claire Chipico, his ex-teammate from last year. He's going to send one up the inside, not quite. Never going to get that one done. Oh, well, Leslie did in CRC, but it's a very hard move to get done. But Alicia Bacini is getting away. As they've got Joey Vrolik, who is right behind Austin Harper. Is he going to have a look down the inside here? Not quite. In his MAT. So that 4 of the race. Here in Sochi. Herdman, who obviously had problems on the first lap. Danny McDonald looking very close to Gaspar Merdialia, but Farnham once again. Is he going to be able to have a look down the inside this time? Is he going to send one up the inside going up to turn one? Not quite. But I think it's McDonald who's the most likely to make the move here, but he thinks better of it. Everyone just being a little bit tentative right now going into the first corner in particular to be able to make a move. Was no DRS in either this or CGP2, it's not been re-enabled yet. So that 5. We've got Mikolai Mabu here, who's going to have a look down the inside. Oh, that could have almost been contact there between Mabu and Sam Venables. But now here you've got Farnham still putting the pressure on Alex Chittock. You've got also Joey Vrolik behind as well, behind Austin Harper. Oh, we got very close. That's very close there between Dan Farnham and Alex Chittick. Chittick going to the inside to Fenn. Farnham might be able to switch back to the inside. Behind, you've got Austin Harper trying to defend from Joey Brolic, who has the outside. There's contact. And Austin Harper has spun it. So, two incidents there. So let's just have a look at how that all spiraled off. I think Farnham waited and took a bit, went out to the slipstream a bit too early, but then behind. Puts Austin Harper into a spin. I don't think there was much Austin. Even though, to be fair to Brolic, Harper kind of got a yellow out there somewhere. So who's had a problem? That is Jake Morgan and Harry Herdman. Harry Herdman really in the wars today. So Harry Herdman really in the wars today in this race. It's not been a good day for him. We are hearing that the incident is being investigated. Between Joey Brolic and Austin Harper. But look at the run. Farnham once again has got on Alex Chittick. Is he going to have a look? He's going to have a look down the inside once again. Chittick goes to the inside to defend. It's Farnham going to send one up the inside. Connor Ellis going to try it around the outside. Going into turn one. Now up towards turn three. Connor Ellis is going to have the inside. And I think he has the position. Connor Ellis. Great driving there from the LAT. But Farnham is going to try it up the inside. Not quite. Who needs DRS? We've got some fantastic racing here. So, Ellis gets past Farnham. After an attempt to get past Alex Chittick, did not work. Pacini seems to have really good pace here today. Apparently Joey said on the team radio about the incident between him and Harper. He went to the inside, he could do nothing. He drifted out to the outside, he could do nothing. And now Farnham is going to be desperate to get that position back. By the way, talking about the home driver, she's currently in 11th, is Temnikova, at her home event. As now here you've got, oh, an incident there. That is Flynn, who's got into a spin, coming together with Jenna Blake. Flynn breaking way too early, and then Blake. Pushed him to a spin. So, lap 8. so far, Pacini has dominated this race. Since joining MAT this year, she really has switched things on. I mean, last year, she was fast. She did get a pole position in Turkey, but she was quite inconsistent. But this year, she has really upped the game a little bit. I think a battle that's now brewing up is now you've got Joey Vrolik catching up to Jacob Arnott. In the battle for fifth. Arnish trying to defend from the MAT driver going to the inside defend. There's contact and there was not much Vrolik could have done about that. And Arnish, I thought that Arnish may have just drifted, and now Arnish has dropped back into seventh. To be fair, yeah, he did definitely just cut back to the racing line. And Joey had no time to react to that, so that was not the best piece of driving there from Jacob Arnott. But Joey is up to fifth now. But probably with a slightly damaged car after those two incidents. The pit stops are probably going to be in the closing stages of this race. Nine cars still running off. We've only had one retirement, that is Hazel Baldwin. Now the field's starting to spread out a little bit. Actually not quite, because now you've got Daniel McDonald right behind Jacob Arnott, heading up towards turn 14. Chittick has escaped from the likes of Ellis and Farnham now. So I think Farnham's being held up by Ellis a little bit. Look at Austin Harper now, who's right behind Claire Chipico. Gonna try it down the inside of turn one. That is nail-biting stuff. I think he might have done it. But Chipico really cutting to the inside. There might be a bit of contact there. Harper has the inside going into turn two. And I think Harper's done it. Yes, he has. Very opportunistic stuff there from Austin Harper. Squeezing his way past. And then Chipico just, there was no contact. Yellow flag out there for some reason. Something happened, I think, in this group. Can't see what happened. Ben Evans, or maybe it's the reason why Ben Evans is not the team. But Shippico just squeezing Harper as much as she could. So, that 12. But Jenny McDonald right behind us, Jacob Arnish in the battle for 7th. Let's see what the MAT can do. Get out there. Oh, we got an incident. That is Sarawi, who's come together with Joe Loughlin. A lot of incidents at turn one here today. Course, all in the same machinery without DRS. Now Lisa Temnikova. Shippico has got back past Austin Harper. Oh, that was over defending there from Harper, ruining a fantastic move that he made. Ben Evans starting to really make his way through the field now. Oh, Rolick's gone. Joey Rolick has had an engine failure. Joey Rolick's out! His engine's gone! From the top 10, that's a shame. We could have seen him make his way to the field. That robs us of quite a lot of action. He came so close to winning in Bahrain and is now out of the race. So, we're half distance now in this race. Here you've got Lisa Temnikova, who this now promotes into the points at her home race. Who's now pressurising Austin Harper. In her racing factory. Oh no! Oh, there's a block up there. That's Temnikova has taken Austin Harper out of the race there. There's a similar incident to Rolick and Arnish. I don't think there's much Lisa could have done there, but I think that could possibly be a safety car here today. But there was not really much Lisa could have done there. Actually there was, because she kind of just steered straight into the back of him. And then Harper's out of the race. It's a shame, he was having a good day. So I think there might be a stewards inquiry on that. And we do have the safety car. We do have the safety car. Thank you. And now that is going to absolutely shatter. Danny McDonald has got ahead of Jacob Arnold. That is going to shatter Pacini's margin. So that, there goes Pacini's massive margin up front that she had. And this is going to put Chituk right behind the MAT. We might not have a very long safety car here today in this one, because all there is to clear that Coombs Academy car away. But that is definitely long enough for Chituk to be brought right onto the tail of Pacini. So, not sure if the entire field will be picked up before. The safety car comes in. So we're going to have one more lap at least under the safety car. And safety car in at the end of this lap. A very short safety car. But now this puts the championship leader right on the tail of the MAT driver. And I think Pacini might have her hands full a little bit, keeping the D-Tech behind her. Especially pit stops have a massive effect, with a few laps later expected to see the pit stops. And the incident between Harper and Temnikova is going to be investigated. So we might just have the whole field caught behind the safety car before it comes in. So, final sector. So, what's going to happen? How is Pacini going to get this restart? So, safety car comes in. And Pacini's in. Pacini, they're all coming into the pits. That is interesting. Chetuk has followed. Of course, the safety car is uncollidable, so they can go as quick as they like. Pacini is in. That is interesting. That is very interesting. Pacini immediately. So who's it? That might have been a mistake, because look at how many cars Pacini's had to wait for. It is all a massive rush. Pacini has lost loads of places. Pacini, this has not worked out. She had to wait for so many cars, and this has allowed Alex Chetuk to take the lead of the race. Absolute drama. This has not worked out well for Alicia Pacini. All these drivers just trying to get some temperature into their tyres. But Alicia Pacini has lost out so badly. Connor Ellis has to come into the pits. I'm pretty sure at the end of this lap. So, Ellis into the pits. Farnham's in as well. But this has cost the race leader so badly. And they all seem to be just building up temperature in the tyres. And it's actually only just put the green flag on now, because Pacini has... Look at how much she has lost out. Because Pacini pitted. And because of this, Connor Ellis actually has emerged into the lead. Venables stayed out. Connor Ellis has actually emerged into the lead. Those who pitted behind the safety car have really lost out. And Benny Plutt is up into second place. Sam Venables is yet to pit. But Chetuk, it could be worse, especially for Pacini. Just the way that she has lost out. Oh, down the inside. There goes Chetuk into a spin. Hit by Gaspar Melody Elliott. Technicolor's back up into sixth. This has completely changed the race. The timing of this safety car. As into the pits comes Sam Venables, so now he's out of the way of everyone. What an interesting race we're seeing here. Benny Plutt up into third. And now Chita got under pressure from Temnikova. And Chittick is really struggling now. We've got a complete change in the race, but where is Bacini going to end up in all this? Because now she's right behind Claire Chipico. Got Dan Farnham right behind her now. Yellow out there again. Oh, we had an incident somewhere. There was an incident in the pits. Oh. That's what happened to Jacob Arnish, Charlie Flynn and Matt Jones have had problems as well in the pits, I'm presuming. So that 20, Bacini having a look down the inside of Claire Chipico. Can't quite get it done. Smoke coming from Ben Evans, and he's been very unlucky this year so far. McConnor Ennis leads the way. This complete new race order that we have. As Bacini trying to get past Claire Chipico. That safety car completely ruined her race. The worst possible time, the safety car. And then the team made a huge mistake by bringing her in. Yellow out there again. That was pretty Ben Evans bringing his car to a stop. What the hell is going to give Temnikova? Because he did. Because she. Jake Varnish is out of the race, so it'll probably be a grip penalty for the next race. And at least this means she might still be able to get a good result on home soil. But Bacini, looking for a way past Chipico. It's all looking good for Connor Ennis at the moment. Who's really lucked out due to the safety car. Bacini getting a very bad exit off of turn 11, and has got Dan Farnham for company. Apparently we're hearing there is going to be some huge words at MAT as to what happened with this strategy call. But Bacini might be able to send one up the inside going in towards turn four here. She thinks about it, but not quite. She jinks to the inside. But that has really compromised, and now she's got to defend from Farnham, now on lap 22 of the race. There's Jack Moss right behind Gina Dicker. In the Amlin Fox. It's just weird that Chittuk seems unable to make any inroads. I see you've got Jenna Blake behind Joe O'Loughlin. The action seems to have cooled down now a little bit after the safety car shaking everything up. So, three laps to go. Are we going to see any moves within the top 10? In a fairly interesting CGP3 race we have seen here today. As Jack Moss has the run on Gina Dicker. So it's penultimate lap here in Sochi. It is Ennis who looks on course for the win. Oh, Shipico defending slightly, and that has put her off guard going into turn three, but not quite. Bacini not quite able to make the move. Side by side behind, this is between Jack Moss and Gina Dicker. Oh, there's contact, and Dicker's gone off. And now that's put her outside the points. And now Jake Morgan and Aaron Bird battling it out. As down the inside goes Mabou on Thomas. So Gina Dicker getting pushed out of the points there. Oh, that's a very slow. Aaron Bird, I think his gearbox is gone. Yeah, his gearbox is gone. Aaron Bird's got a gearbox failure. It really is all kicking off here. Final lap for Connor Ennis. What is that? How's Aaron Bird going to do this? Obviously with a gearbox failure, he's going to be a sitting duck down the straight. He's going to be passed by so many cars there. He's only been passed by one in the form of Ollie Thomas. So many more. But he's doing a good job so far, is Bird, but he's out of the points. But here is Connor Ennis, who looks on course to take his maiden CGP3 victory here in Sochi. In the LAT. As he now heads into turn 18, he comes up to. And he now heads into turn 19. It's Connor Ennis who takes victory here at Sochi. Benny Plutt finishes in second. Gaspar Medi Elliott takes the final podium slot. Chisholm fourth. Tempikova fifth. Shipico sixth. Bacini was robbed. Farnham eighth. Moss ninth. And Morgan takes the final point in 10. So, what an interesting race that was. But we need to see what it's going to do for the championship. but it is Ellis who takes the win. Because we have the podium coming up. 25 points. So what does this do to the championship then? Shittuck still leads, but Melody Elliott takes second. And D-Tech still leads the Constructors. But it's going to be very interesting to see how this is all going to end up. But we're just getting ready for the podium celebrations. But here we go, we're just almost ready. It'll be the British and Irish national anthem. Is it almost time for the podium? A fascinating CGB3 race. Here we go. It's time for the podium.
Mate, I'm going to have to run to the podium.
So, time for the podium.
Enjoyed it hugely. Off we go for the podium. What a great GP2 race.
In third place, it is Gaspar Melody Elliott. In second place, it is Benny Plutt. And the winner, Alicia Bacini. Not Alicia Bacini. It's Conor Ennis. And for him, It is the British and Irish national anthems. Trophy set presentation is about to take place. The winner of the CGP3 Sochi race is Conor Ellis. The second place trophy is going to be presented to Benny Plus. And the third place trophy is going to be presented to Gaspar Medialias. Is now the podium party is going to leave, and then it's going to be time for the drivers to have their photograph. Then it's time for the drivers to get busy with the fizzy as the champagne is sprayed on the Sochi podium. It is Conor Ellis that is victorious in Sochi. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you tomorrow for practice, qualifying, and also the CGP2. As well. Goodbye.